You're here because you know something. What you know you can't explain, but you feel it. You felt it your entire life, that there's something wrong with the world. You don't know what it is.
By us violating those laws, we fell. The Europeans took our science, our mathematics, and ruled the world. We took on his idol god, religions, and fell.
The Matrix is everywhere. It is all around us.
I say it again, you've been had. You've been took. You've been hoodwinked.
We need to understand that we really don't know that we don't know.
They've been racketeering for quite some time, and we have every intention to bring it to a screeching halt. But we can't unless we or you, the people, decide that you want to stop being niggers.
You believe that this is money. You believe that this has actually got value to it.
If that's not addressed by the people on a serious matter, it will be used as it has been used to profile you, to extract revenues from you as chattel property. And most people are under the impression that slavery in the Union State Society had ended. Well, the driver's license is one of the major instruments that is used politically to sustain slavery.
It's a belief system. If we stop believing in this, what is left? I mean, if this really truly had value, here's a nice little test for you. If this really truly had value.
So the deal was, with the fiat currency, you do the same work, but then they would call it Job. You know, like in the Bible, Job, take everything from you, make you curse your God. That's where Job come from.
One God.
Essentially, the next thing that happened, before I could get onto the priesthood of Satanism, excuse me, I had to get seven people to sell our souls to the devil.
We need to get a marriage license.
To do something they have declared to be illegal. Like permission from the government to do the illegal act of driving a car, or fishing, or even getting married.
Why? Because the whole system at large is predicated on commerce. It's now been boiled down to a business relationship. And if you don't think so, I've heard Jordan say this a million times, the first person that you're not going to see is the Lord. You're going to see the attorney, okay? And you're going to talk about who's getting what, and it becomes a matter of contract. So you have to get an application license to marry. So this is what we're operating in over here. We have a three-party marriage.
You don't have a marriage contract with the one you think you love. You have a contract with somebody else who becomes a third party to your life, always.
We have a three-party marriage. But now you have your wife and your husband and the state. And then you get into this, the construct of jurisdiction. The state, if they gave you anything, they can come in and take it away or tell you what to do and how to do it.
If the state comes in and says, you're not treating your children right and we want to take them, right? The first thing you have to say is, state, do I have a contract that says I gave my children to you? Understand that if you belong to the corporate board state, you can't make these arguments because you do have a contract, which is the birth certificate, which is the marriage license.
They can come in and take it away or tell you what to do and how to do it. And then you basically have to live and operate under the codes that are prescribed that dominate the application for the birth certificate, etc. So,
which your marriage license is your contract, is the woman's contract with the state and the man's contract with the state. It's not a contract between the man and the woman. Never was, never will be.
License is certificate or the document itself which gives permission, authority, or liberty given to or forbear for any act.
So the Emancipation Proclamation of 1863 did not set any slaves free.
Even though the very first marriage license wasn't even issued until 1863.
Other information couldn't be expended to you because actually the Emancipation Proclamation dealt with corporations or the transfer of the slaves from the corporate families to the corporate state. It didn't free you. Don't misunderstand that. It means a transfer.
Monarch authorities say is the deeper meaning of the legend. Please listen.
Worshipful Master, I'd like to introduce Brother Smith. Brother Smith, this is our Worshipful Master.
Brother Smith, one might suppose from the jewel you wear about your neck, you were a Master Mason, acquainted with all the secrets belonging to this degree. You were a Master Mason, acquainted with all the secrets belonging to this degree.
Planning terrorism. We know Oklahoma City and World Trade Center was terrorism. We know the Joint Chiefs of Staff wanted to blow up airliners, Baltimore Sun. If you do it, we're going to blame you because we know who's up to it. Or if you let some terrorist group do it, like the World Trade Center, we know who to blame. And you could save the planet. I'm calling it Operation Expose the Government Terror.
And here.
Well, the first thing I want to say is, mandate my ass.
Very mundane people, but...
Well, give me one little story about Jamie.
Very boring person. But a wonderful person, but very boring.
Any Mike Weiss stories?
Mike Weiss, very boring person. Hates to drink, doesn't like to smoke.
That all bar associations hail from the Temple Bar, which is directed at the ends of court, that has a direct affiliation to the Ordo Templar Militaris, which is a Knights Templar organization. And that contract, that covenant to direct all bar associations on the planet is issued through what's called a letters patent. And you guys can look up that term later, but it's a contract that's set up based on the Knights Templar. Who are those guys? Those guys are the guys that founded what's known today as our modern banking system. So.
You have a Republican form of government. This is not a democracy. The democracy are the slaveholders. You'll not see that written in the Constitution because it does not exist in law. It's a fiction. What it represents is the Albion or European nations who set subversives in this order to overthrow the United States Republic without firing a gun. And so when you hear politicians start talking about our democracy, understand that he's probably a Knights Templar. Mm-hmm. Knights of Columbus. They're the financial collectors for the Ku Klux Klan. Give you a god this week to worship and give you another god this week to worship, and they do it from all the branches, whether it's from Islam, whether it's from Christianity, whether it's from Judaism, Buddhism, etc. And they've all been used to enslave the masses. Now that's the truth.